Hey, I got a question for you. Are you an organized person? Like, if I walked into your room, would you have like a system for how all your stuff is organized, or maybe your kitchen and everything? Well, guess what? You're in good company. Windows is the exact same way. Sorry, all you messy people. I'm messy too. It's okay. You see, Windows and most OSs and everything we use now in IT has what's called a file system, which just means it's how Windows organizes all its stuff, how data is organized. Now, by the way, every single device you use, if it has storage, which is every single device you use, has a file system. Your phone has a file system. How those files are organized and stored. Now, back in the day, Windows was using FAT, which I love that they went with that acronym. That's just fun. But it stands for File Allocation Table. It was created back in 1977. That's stinking old, right? This is back when we didn't really think we'd be using much storage. So I think the first iteration could only store up to 200 megabytes total. And like, that wasn't disk size. Like, that was the amount this system could store. You couldn't do anything else, no matter how big the disk was. Now, FAT got a bit fatter. FAT changed into FAT32, which is still around now. You can still use it. Name 32 because you could have a max disk size of 32 gigabytes. That's quite the improvement. Now, the one big downside with FAT32 is that you can't have a file size, an individual file size, larger than 4 gigabytes, which back in the day that wasn't a big deal, but when you think of now about any kind of 4K file or even the video I'm recording right now, it couldn't live on there. It just wouldn't work. You try to transfer it to a flash drive, it wouldn't work. Now, Windows did soon move off of FAT and went to the HPFS, or the High Performance File System. They're not on that now, so I'm not gonna touch on it too much. Just know it gave them more than FAT did. That's all you really have to know. This is not gonna be a history lesson. There won't be a quiz on this specifically, but just know they moved from FAT to HPFS to what we're using now, and that's called NTFS. And this is a big one. You wanna know this one. Now, I love what this acronym stands for. It's the New Technology File System, which is kind of bold, right? Like, this was released, what year was this released? 1993, and they're like, this is the new technology. We're gonna bake it into the name. Nothing will ever beat this. You know what? They weren't wrong. We're still using it. So, Windows has to be installed with the New Technology File System. Now, why is this important? Why is it cool? Well, it now has a max file size of 16 exabytes. So you've heard of megabyte, gigabyte, even terabyte. I don't even know where exabyte falls after that. Just know it's massive, and the day we start to exceed that, I'm a little scared. But it's just big. So you can do whatever you stinking want with the NTFS file system. Now, it wasn't just size. The biggest thing with NTFS is that it's recoverable. So think, if you have files on your file system and they get corrupted or something happens, it'll keep a log of file changes. And you do have the possibility of recovering lost files. Now, a big selling point with NTFS was permissions. We're gonna dive deep into that here in a second. We're actually gonna create some files in Windows and look at the permissions and what we can do with it. Very, very powerful, very, very fun. But first, I wanna point out that NTFS, it's pretty much Windows only. If you were to grab a flash drive, this is not a flash drive, this is my cryptocurrency wallet. Where's a flash drive? I found one. So if you were to format a flash drive with NTFS, which we can do right now, actually, let me try it out. So I plugged in my, what is that? I plugged this in and it said virus on it. This is where I have a bunch of viruses stored. Why did I plug this into my main computer? Okay, fun. Now, in Windows, you can format these hard drives. Now, formatting means you're going to erase everything and possibly change the file system or the way the files are organized. My options here are FAT32. Then we have NTFS. So I could make this Windows only. Plug it into a Windows machine, it works. Plug it into Mac or Linux, they're like, what? What even is this? Get this out of here. But you notice the other option that I haven't covered yet. We have XFAT, which again, it's just a fun thing. It's silly. I'm gonna unplug that virus. XFAT came on the scene in 2006 to fix all of the FAT32 problems. Similar to NTFS, we now have 16 exabytes. Well, my E has 3 lines. We'll leave it there, it's big. 16 exabytes, so that's a lot. The individual file size is now limitless, and it's really just better in every way. So you can format your USB drives as XFAT. They can support whatever they want, and you can use it on pretty much every OS. Now, fun fact, if you have like an SD card for your camera or your phone and stuff, 9 times out of 10, they're gonna be formatted with the XFAT file system. Now, that's really all you gotta know about that.
Thanks for sticking around. To learn more about Windows and other cool stuff, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.